Okay. I believe so.
His side windows, at least, if he's not on the rear window. What is it about us, Dave? As soon as we...
Good. Right. I'm Steve. This is Dave. What's your name?
Aaron.
Aaron what?
Lunsford.
Okay, spell that for me.
L-U-N-S-F-O-R-D.
And it's E-R-I-N?
Yes.
Very good. Aaron, what's it like out here right now?
The roads are crap. And it would be better if people stayed off the roads if they don't know how to drive in it.
You know how to drive in it because why?
I am from Pittsburgh, so I'm used to this stuff. My husband, however, is from Burlington and not, so I had to take him to work and now picking him up from work.
If you didn't have to be on the road today, where would you be?
At home in bed. Or watching the news, telling us to stay off the roads.
Yeah, I mean, you've driven this stuff before in the past. How would you compare what's happening today here in Raleigh to, like, what you dealt with in Pittsburgh?
Oh, Pittsburgh, they don't even clear the roads. It's, you know, you're on your own, but everybody knows how to drive. A lot of people have snow tires. That's not the case here.
So it's just a big mess.
It's a big mess. You should just stay home if you have to.
Thank you, Miss Aaron. You're
Thank
so
you.
Sweet. A little
Thanks.
More than 10 seconds.
Yeah.
Thank you, husband.
No.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you there, you idiot.
No, thank you.
Oh, God, I didn't get so big. You'd also have to have slept.
Cat Audio if I do an interview?
Yeah.
All right, we'll save this for later tonight. Hi there.
Hi. Say hello.
Who's having the most fun right now? You or him or the baby taking the ride?
I think it's the three-year-old. I think he's having the most fun.
You guys are walking because why?
We decided to go to the cafe and get some hot chocolate and just have some time with family.
And decided maybe driving was not the best idea?
Yes. We actually tried to drive out of our neighborhood and started to slide, so we put the car back and just walked.
So walking has been not too bad.
Yeah, it's a bit colder than I'm not totally dressed, but but it hasn't been too bad.
What's your name? Steve, I got you. Oh, hold on a second. Come on. She could have driven over that. Whoa.
Yeah, well. Where's the Eddie? No, gotta go.
Okay. Did you get your name?
Amanda.
Amanda what?
Conrad.
Okay, very good. Who's this?
Hey, what's your name?
Come here, young one.
Wanna say hello?
What's your name, buddy?
Come over here, buddy.
Say your name.
What's your name?
I'm named
Flynn. Tell me how much fun you having.
Are you having fun in the snow?
Yeah.
What's the best part about the snow? What do you like to do in the snow?
Going adventures.
Yeah, adventures. I like that. There you go, my friend. Bye-bye. Okay.
Thank you.
Oh, good. They're talking about the game tonight. Yeah, there's no audio all of a sudden now.
Yeah, whatever.
Okay.
Oh. Okay. Let me see you talk, Steve.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I got you. What are they saying?
It's fine, they got us. Well, Steph, I got to tell you that concern over the roads is the order of the day. We're talking about the secondary roads. I want you to take a look at Everett Street behind me here near Cameron Village. Everett Street looks great. It looks like it's been treated. It's really wonderful. Now let's take a quick turn around about 15 or 20 steps in this direction and take a look at Everett Road. Oops, oh my goodness. It's slick, it's nasty, it's greasy, and it's a real big problem out here. A lot of folks who live in the neighborhood, they're walking over to Cameron Village because they don't want to drive. We talked to one young lady, short time ago, and she said that she and her family decided to go on to Cameron Village to go to a cafe. They pulled out of their driveway. It was slippery. They said, oops, time to walk. Joining me right now is William Guthrie. You're a student at NC State. Earlier today, we talked a lot about the schools, the elementary schools that were closed, but NC State at least started the day with classes, right?
They did. I had an 8 o'clock class, and I woke up, and I kept waiting for the email saying it was canceled, but never came till 11 o'clock.
And then at 11 o'clock, by that time, folks were already on their way in. I guess you had some friends that had some problems?
Yeah, a couple of my friends got in fender benders, a couple accidents, but nothing too bad, I don't think.
You were able to get home from campus right over here to Everett Street. Did you drive or did you walk?
I drove. I kept it on the road most of the time.
Most of the time?
Yeah.
Now, you're from Statesville, so they're a little more experienced with snow out in that neck of the woods, right? A
little bit more, yeah.
But for the most part, how would you say the conditions were today?
Pretty surprisingly bad.
All right, thank you, William Guthrie, a sophomore at NC State, joining us. A bit early, we talked to one young lady who's not from around here. She is, as we say, a Yankee, and she had a different take on the road conditions. But Yankee or Southerner, it really makes no difference when you're dealing with ice, which a lot of these roads have ice underneath the snow cover. It doesn't matter what kind of driver you are, your vehicle just won't go on that. So the word out here is be careful, be cautious, and take your time if you do have to go out by vehicle. Reporting live, I'm Steve Sprazier, WNCN News.
Well, Sharon, walking is the order of the day in this neighborhood in Cameron Village. You take a look at Everett Ave, it looks just fine until you take a few paces over in this direction. And once you turn around here, you can see that the road has got a lot of slickness to it. Take a look at that. That ice is there, just about a millimeter thick, but it's on the road and make driving tough. It has been one of these storms that, well, has just blown folks away. Near Cameron Village, we want to tell you about those secondary roads you were just chatting about. As you can see, walking right now is the order of the day. Here on Everett Ave, it looks pretty good. It looks like it's down to bare pavement, but you don't have to go very far to find that's not the case. Walk about 10 or 15 steps, turn around. Take a look at these guys from NC State. You can see the road is so slick, they can do sliding and sledding right through onto that bare pavement that looks like it's bare pavement, but obviously it is not. This is a storm that has blown us away. Driving, drive with extreme caution, or better still, stay home till April or August. Reporting live, I'm Steve Sprazier, WNCN News. Good night.
The snow's coming, we know the ice coming, and what's the best defense? It's salt. And let me tell you, Cary has a lot of it. Check it out, I'm standing in one of their basins here. They call it the barn, and this is more than 2,400 tons of salt and sand that's ready to hit the roads, again, to hopefully keep us from slipping and sliding all over the place. They got this thing slap full. It goes on even behind me here. Now, Cary, interesting enough, did not use brine on the roads today. They said with the rain coming, it would probably wash it all off anyway. But if you take a look over here, they actually have plenty of their trucks ready to go. They have the sand spreaders ready, and they've got the plows ready. So that's going to be first order of business. Now, across the state, again, they have been brining the roads. They're ready. Tony Tata said today, the Secretary of DOT, that they have plenty of salt to go. And hopefully, as soon as that snow starts to come down, they're going to start attacking it early to keep anything from sticking and refreezing. All right, so just to give you some number ideas across the state, they have more than 2,700 trucks that will be on the road. More than 14,000 employees are going to be out there, 1,400, excuse me. And as far as salt across the state, 162,000 tons. Now, just for some fun, we did some math there. That's about enough to put enough salt on 506 billion orders of large fries at McDonald's. So it looks like for this storm, they're pretty sure that we've got plenty of salt. We'll send it back to you guys. Thank you. Dude, it was a disaster or something. They took video. It took like 10 seconds to run this off for some reason. I heard myself during the whole tag. 3, 2. Let's just do salt. Okay. 3, 2. Good evening, I'm Jonathan Rodriguez. We know the snow's coming, we know the ice is coming, right? So what's the best defense? It's salt. And let me tell you, Carrie has plenty of it. Check this out. I'm standing on top of a 2,400-ton pile of salt and sand. It's in this basin that they call the dome here, or the barn, and this thing is just slap full, even behind me. And the Secretary of DOT says across the state, they are good to go on salt. They're ready to attack those roads as soon as it starts. Sorry. At that. Well, good evening. I'm Jonathan Rodriguez. We know the snow's coming. We know the ice is coming to hit our roads, right? So what's the best defense? It's salt. And check this out. Carrie has a lot of it. I'm standing on top of 2,400 tons of salt and sand mixture. This is their largest basin that they have here. And you can see it is slap full all the way even behind me. They call this the dome, and they have plenty of salt across the state as well. Secretary of the DOT says they are ready to go for this storm. They have the spreaders out, they'll have the plows out, and hopefully this will be a quick moving storm. We'll have more on WNCN.com.
Done here in about 60 seconds.
All right, I'll wait.
Okay, thank you.
Hey, good evening, guys. Yeah, we know the snow's coming. We know the ice is coming. So what's the best defense? Well, it's salt. Let me tell you, the town of Carrie has plenty of it. I'm standing in what is called the dome. This is 2,400 tons of salt and sand that is ready to hit the roads, hopefully prevent us from slipping and sliding all over the place. This thing is massive. It goes probably another 20 feet behind me here. This is the biggest basin that they have here on the site. Now, interestingly enough, the town of Carrie did not grind their roads today. They said since it might start as rain and then turn over to snow, they didn't want to just wash off. But their trucks are ready to go. In fact, the second round of crews are getting them prepped right now. They have the spreaders on there. They have the plows on there. And as soon as that snow starts to come down, they're going to be out there scraping. And we talked to the Secretary of DOT, Tony Tata. He says they have enough salt to get us through this storm across the state.
Look, it's coming down.
You see it?
Yes, it's coming down. Look, you can see it up here in real life.
I see this gain.
No. You'll see it. Just watch. No, look, there it comes. Look.
Yeah, there it is.
As the first
tweet.
Yeah, that'd be cool if there was a spot where we could find one shot and then show how it changed. Like, this is what it was like, time-lapse.
Well, yeah, it won't be time-lapse, but it'll be a shot of snow falling.
Make sure I'm cleaned up here.
You're good.
I have to take that out.
Okay. Good to go? Yeah. Check, one.
Sinacra. You're good. First.
So if I can get your first and last name.
Yeah, it's Tony Thomas.
Tony Thomas. So what are you doing out here?
I'm just running. You know, I love it. I mean, this is absolutely gorgeous. It reminds me of a home in Pennsylvania, so I'm not bothered by this at all.
Oh, so you're used to this.
Oh, yeah, no doubt.
How about the road conditions?
Road conditions right now seem to be fine. I haven't been out, but if they're anything like they were yesterday morning, it'll be pretty bad.
Yeah.
By morning, it'll be a nightmare if you try to get out.
So what makes you want to still come out here and run while it's still...
Gotta lose a few pounds and, you know, keep the momentum going.
Cool. What's the best part for you?
What's the best part?
Yeah, about all this.
I don't know. Everything. Just the beauty of it. All you got to do is just look. It's just gorgeous. Really.
Awesome.
So you got to get a shot like right there. That is absolutely magnificent.
Oh, they're just coming down so slow. So what do you expect and what do you think we're going to get?
I have no idea. I didn't listen to the weather report. Just other people who said we're going to get about 8 inches. So who knows? We'll see.
Plans for the rest of the week?
Not really. Just enjoy.
Awesome. All right, I'll let you get on your way. He's going to grab some video of your run. Good evening, I'm Jonathan Rodriguez. Rain, sleet, and snow falling across the triangle here in Cary. The crews are getting ready with their plows and sand to clean up our roads. We'll have the latest look at your conditions and your forecast coming up next at 11. Good evening, I'm Jonathan Rodriguez. Rain, sleet, and snow falling across the triangle here in Cary and all over the state. Crews are working to keep our roads.
Okay, go.
3, 2. Good evening, I'm Jonathan Rodriguez. Rain, sleet, and snow falling across the triangle and all across the state and right here in Cary. Road crews are prepping with their plows and salt to make sure our roads aren't slick and slippery. We'll have the latest look at your forecast and current conditions coming up at 11 right here on WNCN.
to shoot from the window.
You better turn that thing on.
I think that light helped a lot for shooting, actually.
Heck yeah, dude. That light was amazing. See when it gets... Turn that on!
Turn the wipers off for a second. Never mind.
Or just go. Think we good?
Go for it. don't want her out here on the roadway. We're going to go ahead and give her a ride home. But if somebody, law enforcement, comes behind me, they'll know the vehicle's empty. So they don't have to stop and waste time. Trailer. Said they were both traveling along, and he was trying to go past her. She started to slide a little bit, and then as her back end came around, he smashed her right in the back left.
Kept going.
So, but I've almost been hit.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Y'all be safe.
All right. Bye. Thank you. You too. Transformer.
Okay.
So where's the tree you took that one down?
Church because we need to pull them take down and move the trails with them in the back side.
You actually gonna report from right here?
Yeah, if we can. We got a little mobile live unit.
Great.
Hey, Johnny.
No, as a matter of fact, I was going to last night. You might want to come a little bit.
He said they're about to.
That's why you want your lawn.
Yeah, get a hole for it or snap that one out or something.
Yeah, he said they're about to pull it.
Yeah, the chains.
They're going to drill it.
Spread it. Yeah. I'll put the bottom.
pulling in to my hand.
All right, for a quick mic check, can you count to five?
Yeah, Jeff Brooks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Gotcha. So just kind of describe the situation around just our area right now. What are we looking at as far as power outages?
Well, we're continuing to see a number of outages here across Wake County and Durham County. Those numbers have come down since the peak of about 215,000 earlier today, and that's good news. We've seen crews come in from other parts of the state, including crews like these that came from the Wilmington area and other areas that weren't as affected by the storm. Those crews have helped to add to the 1,000 or so additional crews that are located here every day, and that's helped to speed restorations throughout the day.
What's the biggest problem you guys are facing right now?
Well, you know, we've seen a lot of down trees and down limbs. These are the heavy snow and the ice has really just caused, you know, thousands, 3,000 plus outages that have to all be addressed. And sometimes they're as simple as replacing out a fuse, something quick like that, or like a broken pole. And that can take an hour or more. And so we're seeing a lot of variety of outages. The roads are still a bit slushy and they're going to get icy as the night goes on. So a lot of things to consider.
What are you guys expecting for tomorrow?
Well, you know, our hope is to get as many as possible on tonight. We're going to get the majority of the folks in this area on tonight. Some may carry into tomorrow, and we'll continue doing that until we can get done. Obviously, we have to make sure our crews are safe and doing their work, but we also recognize that our customers are cold and they want their power back. So these guys are committed to getting the lights on as soon as we can.
Gotcha. And I know they want to know win, but it's hard for you guys to tell a lot of times, right?
Well, it is hard. It is hard. We're doing our best to kind of develop a strategy that restores the most people as quickly as possible. But when we get down to those individual outages that are 1, 2, 3 homes, those are going to take a while given the number of outages that we have. But we'll be working well into the evening and we'll work to get as many on as we can today.
I know one of the things you said last time we were looking at some power outages is for people that don't assume that you guys know about every outage. So still, people should still report every time they have one?
Yeah, that's right. You know, we're still seeing a few outages pop up along the system. And if you do experience an outage, go ahead and report it because that helps us know that you're out of power. And when we go in and do a restoration, maybe we restore a line, we'll be able to verify that you got your power back on as well. So that's certainly something that we encourage.
Cool. Anything else people should know about through tonight?
Yeah, just, you know, we're still having a lot of down lines as we're working, and so those down lines, assume that those are energized lines and stay away from them. As it gets dark, it's going to be harder to see things. The roads are also going to become icy. You know, we've seen a lot of these poles that were hit by cars. So let's stay off the roads and help our crews. If you see them ahead, slow down, give them some room to work.
And you guys have hundreds of people out right now, right?
Right now, we have hundreds of people, 1,000 or so from this area, plus another 1,000 that have come in. So there are crews working all over the triangle tonight, and they're going to be working well into the night to get these lights back on.
Real quick, you know, it's a pretty bad storm every year, stuff like that happens. And you got so many crews working, pulling people from around, a lot of extra money. Why not put all these lines underground?
You know, a lot of people do ask, why don't you put these lines underground? And the reality is cost to customers is one reason. It's significantly more expensive to put those lines underground. And putting them underground doesn't necessarily guarantee that you won't have outages. You know, I, for example, live in a neighborhood with underground lines, and they've had to come in and replace those. So it can happen with underground lines just as it can with overheads. So there's a balance to each. We try to strike the balance. And we've maintained a 99.97% reliability. So we're still being pretty good even with all that. And we'll get the lights back on from this as well.
Is Wake County the most that you've seen, for sure, the hardest hit?
That's right. Wake County and Durham were the hardest hit in this storm. We did see outages across the state from Charlotte all the way towards the coast, but really this was the heart of where the most outages were. Even at its peak, more than half of the outages were located right here in Wake County and Durham County. So that's where we're concentrating most of our efforts today.
Perfect.
Rodriguez, crews all over the triangle working to restore power to thousands of homes across the triangle. Take a look at this one. This was a power pole that was hit by a car. They actually just erected the new utility pole. They're working on getting that all rewired so they can restore power to the hundreds of homes in this area. This is the scene really across the area. Wake County, Durham County, Orange County. Duke Energy says they're not quite sure exactly how long it will take to get all the power restored, but they will be working throughout the night to try to get that power turned back on and expecting more power outages throughout the night. I'm reporting in Raleigh, Jonathan Rodriguez. All right, so just kind of walk me through. So it was last night, huh? Just kind of walk me through when you lost power and what happened.
The neighbors told me they thought it was around 3:45.
In the morning?
Mm-hmm.
So how cold did it get?
I have my thermostat set on 70 when I went to bed, and right now it's 58.
What's it like?
Cold. I've got all the blankets on, the afghans, and I woke up at 8 o'clock and then went back to sleep and then woke up again, and I knew something was wrong that second time I woke up.
And is it just kind of what's it like? Is it just a waiting game at this point?
Yeah, I mean, I've turned on every light in the house 2 or 3 times. You know, I'm used to flip the light. Can't do anything without electricity, you know.
So what have you been doing today? What do when you have no power?
You read. That's what I've been doing, is reading. I have a library book, and I've been making good use of that.
Gotcha.
And eating.
Yeah, there you go. You have to. Mm-hmm. Did you expect something like this when you heard snow?
Mm-mm. No.
And this is a whole neighborhood, correct?
Yeah, it is. I think the transformer that we use is on North Hills Drive. Mm-hmm. We have underground wiring, gas and electric, but the transformers on North Hills, and that gave us a problem one time before when we had several years back. We had weather like this, and it was the transformer on North Hills.
Gotcha. So what's the plan now?
My plan is to get out of Dodge. No, I would really rather stay here, but I'm not that keen on the roads, you know. So I'm really not decided what to do. Whether to take a chance on staying here and getting colder than 58 degrees in here, or take my chance on the road.
But you do have families in the area who has power.
Yeah, my daughter.
That's good. Mm-hmm. So I guess, so what's the hope of this whole neighborhood, that it gets turned around?
Yeah, we all kind of snowed in. Most of us, that's a mixed neighborhood, couples and single people. Mm-hmm. But there's a few older people like me, but then there's some young people. So we have a mixed neighborhood.
Have you heard from the power company at all when it could possibly be back on?
My daughter said she called, and they told her that it hopefully today. Yeah, but I don't know. I don't know how to get in touch with them. I have digital phones. I mean, with Time Warner, I have phone service with them.
Okay.
And the power goes out, the phones go out.
So you got no heat, no phone.
No. I got a cell phone, and I'm hoping it don't go out. I hope I have some minutes left on that.
And some battery life.
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha.
Yeah, my family has, I'm the only one that has a land phone. The rest of them have.
Cell phones.
Uh-huh.
Everybody's moving to that.
Yeah.
Well, anything else you want to add? That's just what we wanted to talk about.
I would just like to know how I can find out how long it'll be. That would be a comfort to know if it's going to be another hour or all night.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know if they've announced it on TV or not.
If there was a better way. We've literally just talked with them, and he said they're hoping tonight, but there could be some that go well into tomorrow.
Yeah.
So it's kind of one of those things that we don't
know
either.
It's just like I said, the neighbor had pulled it up, and it showed they had made a lot of repairs in North Raleigh. Because I think to begin with, I heard somebody say they had over 1,000 customers.
Mm-hmm.
And but in mapped out this area, this particular area where I live, it did not have the word repair online. It just had assessment. So I don't know what that means. That means that they might or can, or they might can't.
Yeah. Okay.
And said they were working hard trying to repair it. But
yeah.
So far.
It's just they've had so many across the area that it's just like, when are they going to get
done? Yeah, and if I get to feeling real sorry for myself, I think about those people in Boston and places like that that's really had it a whole lot worse than we've had it this one day.
That's
so.
Like this one day for 3 weeks
mm-hmm.
for them.
That makes me feel better.
That's good.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And
actually, can you stick this in your pocket, this part here?
Drop that right into your pocket, into that one.
Yep.
Yeah.
That way I don't have to. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. And then just show,
this
I guess.
This is the thermostat.
Okay. So what did you have this set at now?
I had it set at 70.
And where are we at now?
58.
Whew.
And I started turning the light on.
I do the same thing.
And this, I'll let you tell you what I do without this. You can't see it. It's a zip up, long sleeve hooded, and I don't have, I don't know what it is.
It's like a blanket jumpsuit, huh?
Yeah, you got it. This on top of bathrobe.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, jeans and a turtleneck. This bathrobe.
Lots of layers.
And this bathrobe, maybe.
There you go. Oh,
hooded emergency blanket. It lives in West Raleigh.
This area got a lot. It really did. And it's that real heavy, wet snow, so it's just been bringing down.
Is it slushy out?
Mm-hmm. It's slushy, so,
so
it's just bringing
in.
Down branches. And you can walk in it, sure. It's just going to be real messy and real cold. Better than our last storm, because at least that plows off the roads a lot cleaner than the solid ice. So.
Well, at this point in time, I'm really hoping that we get it back restored.
Mm-hmm.
I just got rid of the other one.
Are you calling your phone? Okay. Can we just ride around for a couple of times? I do that.
Yep.
Rough.
Long days.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's not that bad. Like, it's cold, but I feel bad for the old people. So there's a lot of like, he's like, who are these people? Come here.
Does he have a mustache going on?
He got half a mustache.
Half a mustache? That's awesome.
Meow. Aww.
Okay. Good to go. And you can just talk with me. You don't have to stare into the camera.
Okay.
That way it's not awkward for you. So if you can say and spell your first and last name so we get it right, please.
It's Liv, L-I-V.
Okay.
Jorgensen, J-O-R-G-E-N-S-O-N.
Good? Uh-huh. Cool. All right, so what's it been like? What have you been doing today?
I have been sitting here with this little guy, just doing our best to stay warm and sleeping and reading. That's about it.
Yeah, when did you notice the power went
on? When I woke up at like 7 this morning.
You just gonna flip on?
I was like, no, I looked at the clock. It was black. It's like, yep.
Yeesh.
No power.
Has it been dropping temperature pretty quick?
It's actually not all that bad.
Yeah.
It could be worse.
So what do you do now? Just a waiting game?
I guess. Thinking about going to a hotel tonight, my plan was to make a lasagna for dinner, but that's not happening because we have an electric oven. So at this point, yeah, waiting game, maybe go check into a hotel.
Yeah. So what don't you have? I mean, obviously lights. I mean, what else is electric?
Well, we have hot water, which is good. So I just took a hot shower and that felt great. Getting out into the cold air did not feel great. But I got this gas fire here and blankets. But other than that, it's the heat, electricity. You got to flip on the light switch in the closet. Oh, it's gone.
You forget, Abby,
yeah,
right?
It's kind of silly.
And you said there are, unfortunately, some elderly people in this neighborhood who are dealing with the same thing, too.
Yeah, so I could only imagine how much tougher it must be on the older people. So it is sad.
Have you heard from Duke Energy at all?
We've just been checking online, but no.
What are your hopes or thoughts?
Hopes? That'll turn on any second now. But the reality is, we'll see. It's pretty bad. We walked around this morning, noticed some serious damage to lots of lines just out here on North Hills Drive. So no real expectations for anything immediate.
And you said you had some in your backyard as well, right?
Trees down in the backyard, tons of damage to 10-year-old trees, which is pretty sad because there's no immediate fix for that.
Have you been, you're new to the area, right?
I've been here a year.
Okay. Is this the first snowstorm you went through?
Yeah. I'm a teacher, so I've worked one day in the past 2 weeks. So I'm kind of like, what day is it? What's going on? Wait, another snowstorm? Another day off? So it's been kind of funny. But, yeah, my first storm.
You guys aren't going to have a spring break, are you?
My school, fortunately, we don't have to make up.
Oh.
So.
Any of the days so far?
No. Wow. I'm in a private school.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
That's great. Yeah. Well, all right, so what's next? You said you may go to a hotel for now. You're just going to wait it out as long as you can? And then.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Any advice for people who are sitting out in their cold?
Crank up your fireplace if you have one, and blankets work. And so do cats when they don't run away.
Cool. I think that's all we needed.
Yeah.
Good.
Thank you so much.
Roscoe's like, I'm out of here.
I know. Come back, kitty. What time are you guys airing your story?
You will be on as long as everything goes according to plan at 6.
Okay.
So in about an hour and a half. So we're going to go put all this together. We've been hanging out with Duke a little bit this morning.
Without the dumb parts. You can't really see the damage from here. You can kind of, if you go out on the deck, you might.
Mm-hmm.
But you can see, it, like, that's a good example of where it snapped off. So in the summer, this is like our drain pipe. And as soon as we went into Be Good, and it was surprisingly full.
Yeah.
Probably like 20 people there.
Mm.
I love that place.
That's awesome. Yeah, we were out over on Falls of Noose, and a car plowed through a utility pole. And so they were working on getting that put back in, and it knocked out, I said, about 400 houses there.
Yikes.
So, but
was
you guys,
the person okay?
Yeah, from what we heard, but who knows.
Good.
Yeah,
ours is just ice on the lines, I think.
Yeah.
Better for me.
I'm going to start cutting. Oh, you got a car.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Look at the street pole.
In front of, like, a certain house, or maybe...
No.
Oh, you mind if we just get a little warm on the fire?
Hey, good evening, guys. Yeah, it was since about 3 o'clock this morning, these neighborhoods, these families have just been waiting, waiting, waiting for their power to come back on without heat, without lights. And then about 40 minutes ago, we're setting up for our live shot and boom, power comes back on. You can see the street lights behind me. And there are people outside cheering. They were just ready for this power. Now, that's not the same story across the county. As you said, a lot of people still waiting. We were riding around with Duke Energy. They say you never know what you're going to get when you're on a call. It can be something as simple as a fuse or some wires that were what we saw here, or something as complicated as we saw on Falls of Neuse near Millbrook. This is video from earlier. For about half the day, the entire road was shut down because crews tell us a car ran into one of the utility poles out there. And of course, that's a lengthy process. They had to pull that old pole up. They had to dig out a new hole, put the new utility pole back in, get the whole thing rewired. And that affected hundreds of people in that area. Now, they were able to get that finally turned back on. But again, it keeps utility crews from being able to answer the number one question that people have. And that's, when is my power going to come back on? That's the question these people in this neighborhood had. We talked to one lady who was staying as warm as she could. Her temperature dropped down to 58 in her house. They were using anything they had to stay warm. Blankets. One lady was even just snuggling with her cat next to the fire and contemplating whether they should stay or leave.
Inside.
What's the daylight delay?
4 seconds. 4 seconds.
Oh, okay.
Again, Jeff Brooks there saying that they hope to have everything restored by tonight, but they know that they're going to have some. They're going to continue into tomorrow. Their number one goal is to get all the power turned on. They have to, of course, keep their crews safe, but they know there's people out there who are relying on heat for that power to come back on. So we'll keep you updated right here on WNCN. Guys, back to you.
All right, you guys are clear. Thanks.
There you are. Thanks. Thanks, Gary.
Bye.
Okay, come down.
There you are. Look, there you are.
Did it show the cat?
Oh, yeah, her shot was on.
Okay,
her.
Good.
Yeah.
That's funny.
There's your box.
Check, check. All right, if we can get your first and last name, if you'll
okay.
Say and spell it for me.
My name is Barbara Latta, and B-A-R-B-A-R-A. Latta is L-A-T-T-A.
Perfect. And you can just talk with me and pretend he's not even there.
Okay.
Perfect. So tell me when you first lost power and what it was like.
Well, we woke up cold in the middle of the night. It was about 3 o'clock, and I got up to turn up the heat, and we had no heat and no lights, nothing. And so we went back to bed and stayed as long as we could until about 9:45, and we got up to get a little something to eat because we were hungry. And kept thinking that the power would come off. But when I was up, I did call Duke Power. And so they said, okay, we have it recorded that you have reported it in your area, and we'll get to work on it. So I kept thinking, well, it'll come back on. And at lunchtime, it still wasn't on. So I went next door and borrowed a tea kettle of hot water and brought it home and made hot chocolate and hot apple cider, and then we ate cold food. We had some time to drink, but cold food. And so then this afternoon, I kept waiting and waiting. So about 4:30, I called and I said to Duke Power, can you just give me any idea when it might come on? Do you think it will come on tonight? I said, I really have to make a decision whether we're going to stay here and be cold all night, or do we go somewhere and find a shelter? And he said, I can't tell you. He said, I know, and I told him where I lived, and he said, people are in your area. They are working on it, but have no idea what time it will be on. So I called my son to tell him that we were going to try to find shelter because we had been without electricity all day and we were really getting cold. And so he said, call the Red Cross. And he gave me the number because he's a volunteer, so he knew the number. And the real nice lady answered the phone, and she said, oh, we have a shelter at Sanderson High School, and it opens at 5 o'clock. And I said, perfect. We'll be there to help them open. And so my husband was really thrilled. He was so happy that we had some place to go, because if they hadn't had a shelter, we were just going to get in the car and drive to Crabtree and try to find the hotel, which is what some of our neighbors had already done. They had already gone. And see, we have no television, no radio, no computer. We had no way of finding out what was going on and who was getting power, who wasn't, except nobody in our neighborhood had it. We knew that. And so, because when the electricity goes, you don't have anything. And so I did have my cell phone, but I didn't want to use all my power calling every hotel. And so we were just going to get in the car and ride to Crabtree and find a hotel that had a place for us. But when we found out that Red Cross had a place, we decided to come right here. And we came in, and they had hot pizza for us. First thing we'd had hot in 24 hours, because last night we had dinner, nothing today for lunch. And so we were thrilled. And it's just a great thing that they're doing for people who don't have electricity. And so I commend the Red Cross, and they work with disaster relief in Raleigh and Wake County. And so all of these programs, first time I've ever used it, first time I've ever been out of a warm house. So I'm just thrilled at the, and they were just so nice and welcomed me and said, you know, come on in and we'll have pizza 7 o'clock or something. And they have cots set up. So we have a bed. Oh, and they gave us a little kit that had toothbrush, soap, toothpaste, all the things that I don't know why I didn't think to bring and didn't. It was just like I was going out for a ride or something. And so all the essentials we have. So I'm all set. And I've even taken off both my jackets now. I still have on a couple of shirts and a couple of pair of pants, but it's so warm in here. And it just feels so good. You don't appreciate the warmth until you don't have it, and you keep getting colder and colder and colder, and you don't know where you can find warm. So, we're here.
You found it with some pizza. That's awesome. Are you hopeful that your power's going to be on tomorrow?
Oh, yes. Yeah. I am. I'd like to go home, you know, eventually. I mean, yeah, this is going to be nice, but sleeping on a cot, I just as soon get back to my king-size bed.
Well, you were great. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. That's pretty much what we needed.
It did.
Stumbling around
in
the dark.
No right now, light. I'm content. And, of course, then the hot water got colder all day, so we didn't have hot water. But thanks to a neighbor, she did put hot tea and that, and we ate a cold lunch.
Where is your neighborhood at?
Shadowwood Lane. It's very close to Shelley Lake, and I go out and run there every day and come back. Didn't quite get all the way around the lake.
You still did it though? Wow, good for you.
Well, started. But
maybe at 2 o'clock,
we're telling people to stay inside if they can.
Right.
And get this word out about shelters too.
Yeah, get the word out. Right. And I was so glad he reminded me. And I knew that, I guess, at the Red Cross Theater. I just never needed it before or hadn't really thought about it today. And when he said
that,
nice to meet you.
Enjoy your night.
Oh, I will.
Thank you. Thank you. I'll be back tomorrow.
Oh, yes. Please.
All right, thank you. Cool. Thank you guys very much. You appreciate it.
Y'all, let me find it.
Yeah. Right. Yes, sir. So we'll be in the truck editing this stuff and getting it all ready to go. So.
I know that's right.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you, guys.
Y'all stay warm.
All right.
And last check from Duke Energy, just here in Wake County alone, still more than 12,000 people without power. So still a lot of work that needs to be done. Reporting live in Raleigh, I'm Jonathan Rodriguez, WNCN News.
Thank you, Amy. Thank you very much.
So we'll get your names at the end. So when did power first go out for you guys?
Went out about 3:30, 4 o'clock Thursday morning.
How'd you notice it?
I just heard it blink and the phone. And
I woke up cold.
And so then about after 3:30, it just went out. And,
so this is Thursday, right? Mm-hmm.
This is Thursday morning, yes.
So what was Thursday like?
Well, I went to work and...
I went to my daughter's because she had electricity, and then I came home and the house was freezing. It was about 50 degrees, so we went to a hotel.
She called last night on the way home from my daughter's and said that she was going to go stop and get something to eat. And when I got in and it was cold, I said, I don't know about you, but I'm ready to go to a hotel. Staying here that all night long and having to get up early this morning to get back to work, I said...
We had cable and TV and internet.
Yeah, it was much better indeed.
So you come back, where are we at now?
What?
As far as electricity.
Well, they're supposed to be having it on 11:45 tonight is what the call-in service says.
So what's the plan?
We're going to go out to dinner and come back and hopefully it's on.
I came home again today and the house was 50, so I just wrapped up and turned the logs on and just... stayed there.
Yeah, I'm about to say, what do you do when your house is 50 and you have no
nothing.
Power?
You just wrap up.
Yeah.
And nothing. I was going to, got up to work and I said, I can't even wash clothes. Oh,
fine. It's edited.
Yeah, please
it's
do.
Edited. You're fine.
But it's...
I got home and I wanted to do some things and then I realized there was no ice. There was nothing.
Yeah.
I couldn't cook.
Couldn't wash dishes because of no hot water.
Mm.
So
it's everything. And this is street-wide, right?
Mm-hmm. This whole road right here.
So what have neighbors been doing?
Well, I heard generator running next door. My son-in-law's got a generator running.
Across the road.
So some of them have generators. I just didn't worry about trying to get mine out, and we would fend to one way or another.
So are you guys going to risk it and try to stay here tonight?
No, we're going to our children's house if it's still cold tonight.
Yeah, definitely. Are you hopeful, though?
I'm hopeful, very hopeful.
We've all got bets. 8 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock. The children came over and placed bets today.
To see who won the power. And why do you think it took so long for this area?
Just a road that has 13 customers on it, not priority.
That's it.
It only got 13 calls, so there's only 13 of us. So we're not a. I understand. Yeah. We're not a priority.
We don't have anyone that's really needy on this road that requires electricity, so
just don't realize how much you miss it till it's gone.
Oh, absolutely.
And we're absolutely. Rural Johnston County, so
gotcha. All right, guys. Well, that's
you mentioned the call-in service. Have you been checking that? Has that number been changing at all, or has it always been?
Yeah, have you noticed any changes and when?
In the time? Mm-hmm. No, it's been 11:45 since yesterday. Hmm. Same story, 11:45.
And a lot of some of the other ones that said 6:30 latest today, it seems to be the most common one. Yeah. Do you think they're legit numbers or hard to tell?
Hard to tell. I mean, I really don't know. From experience, I don't know how to judge it.
Were you guys expecting power outages from snow?
I was not. I mean, I really was not looking for that. It was a wet snow, not thinking about freezing rain this time. Mm-hmm. I was expecting it the last week, but not today.
Did you see the source of the problem? Do you?
I have not. I've not noticed anything. Supposedly, towards the end of the road, back in some of the woods.
Hmm. And you heard it was a transformer or something, possibly?
No, it
I think so.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. All right, guys.
They 13 of us out, but that just ain't right. I mean, we ought to be just a priority as. Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're good. Good to go. All right, so if we can get your first and last name, if you'll spell it, so I get it right, please.
Belinda O'Neill, it's BELINDAONEAL.
Perfect. Good on mic. Mm-hmm. All right, perfect. So just kind of walk me through how this happened, when it first happened.
Yesterday morning I woke up And well, he's on oxygen, and his oxygen kept going, his machine kept going on and off, and it finally it dawned on me that it was the power going on and off, and so I just finally turned that off, and then all of a sudden the power went out, and that was about 7:30 something like that yesterday morning, and we have not gotten power back since.
What's it been like for you?
Sort of tough, because having to look after him like I do, and not have any way to have any water to clean him up with, and you know, trying to make sure he stays warm, because he's my top priority.
Sure. And tell me about what your husband's facing right now.
He has congestive heart failure, and he's we've had hospice coming out, and we're fixing to turn his pacemaker defibrillator off. In fact, we would have done it probably this week had he not had we not lost power. So, but it's sort of tough when you got one that's like that, some patient that's like that you're looking after with no power.
So, I mean, this isn't about just like, yeah, we need lights on. I mean, this is crucial.
Yeah, because if it wasn't for him, I could handle it. Me just by myself, you know, I could handle it. But I just don't want him to be cold and him to be where he can't, you know.
So tell me, and you've made calls, correct?
Oh, yes, several times, about every couple of hours, and I get the same. Up until, I think it was last night, they didn't have no estimated time at all for when we get it back on. And finally last night when I called, they give me the time of 11:45 p.m., which if tomorrow, in other words, Friday at 11, which is tonight. And we haven't got anything yet, so I'm just waiting until 11:45 to see what if they come back on.
Are you hopeful?
Oh, very hopeful.
Yeah. You said you've been praying all day?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
What's the hardest part for during all this?
Probably not having running water. You know, you're so used to going to the spigot and turning on. Well, in the country, you ain't got no water if you ain't got no power. That's just ain't gonna happen. So
what have you guys been doing to stay warm?
I've got the generator going, and thanks to one of my neighbors up the road, I could not, when I first went to turn it on, I could not get that thing cranked to save my life and soul yesterday. And I pulled and pulled. And one of my neighbors came down here and pulled it and cranked it for me. And then one of my second cousins came down and made sure I had enough gas to last me through to yesterday and brought me some gas. And so we've got a little electric heater in the bedroom, and I've got that going. And I actually cooked dinner with an electric frying pan yesterday, and I called dinner. That's what everybody else calls lunch. But I'm from the country, so.
That's right. That's dinner. Gotcha. All right. Well, so are you, I mean, if what's the plan if it doesn't come on tonight?
Well, fill the generator back up, keep her going. So that's all I can do. Yeah. I have it. They've told me that, you know, I could always carry him to a hospice house. But we have not had to do that so far. And I don't want the weather to have to do it now. And as long as I can keep him in there like that and keep him warm, I'll be okay.
You know, hearing some people got their power on in 20 minutes, some people now waiting 20 days. Why do you think that is, that it takes so long for areas like this?
Well, I think we're put on the back burner because we're out in the country. And which, you know, I can understand they've got to get the hospitals first and things like that. But then, you know, with just like us, now there's not but 13 of us down our dead end road. And why are we having to wait so long when it's probably just something minor? Because we don't see where there's no, and I know something could be further up the line that I hadn't seen. But where other people on 39 Highway have got power. But down Driver Road where we live, nobody has got power. And there's just not but 13 of us down here. So I don't see why that, you know, they should, it looks to me like they could just come on out here and check that out and plop, you know, we got power and go on and wait on somebody else.
Be done. Gotcha. So what's your, I guess the final thing is, what's your message to Duke, your plea to Duke Energy?
Please, please, please get us power soon. And I sure will be blessed by it.
Sure, absolutely. Well, hopefully, you know, they'll hear your story and hear your neighbor's story. Get out of here. Mm-hmm. If it's not already done tonight.
Maybe it will be. Well, what I'd be normally doing is sitting here like this.
Yes. Well, how do you check on blankets and everything and make sure he's doing good? I mean,
what do you sort of do? Just tuck them in, make sure everything's good?
So you guys were in here, and then you heard the machine going off, you said?
It's an oxygen machine, and I kept hearing it going off and on, off and on, off and on. And that sort of, I don't sleep heavy, because they used to tell you when you're a mama, you hear the blanket fall off a baby. Since he's been sick, I've been that way with him. And yesterday morning when his oxygen thing kept going, I was in one of those moods to where half asleep and half awake, and I'm thinking, why is that still going on and off like that? Maybe there's something wrong with it. And then I looked and the clock was off. And then finally it went off completely. So he's got a backup oxygen tank when he needs it that we've got in the closet. So.
And that tank is run by electricity, though, correct?
Well, the backup tank isn't, but that one over there is.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. So. Okay, and tell me about the power situation. So you were able to get a generator. What is it?
Right. I got the cords running through from the little bathroom window in there and draped them. I got one going to the refrigerator and one going so he'll have the TV to be able to watch and be able to keep him occupied and keep the heater, so the heater stay going. Thing up.
I don't blame you. I don't blame you one bit. Oops, sorry. And
when heartburn comes creeping upon you, fight back with relief so smooth, it's fast. Tums Smoothie starts dissolving the instant it touches your tongue.
That's why we're going to turn it on. And he'll have tremors. And I had to make sure if he does, he's turned over on his side. And sometimes when he's over on his side, it'll stop. But, just basically try to, keep him as warm as possible. And
I have time. Well, I mean, can you sort of show me just how you, just
wrap him up good?
Yeah.
Just keep him all tucked in and mm-hmm. make sure his his cover is all nice and cozy and warm. If left untreated, it can lead to liver damage and potentially even cancer. Isn't that right? And let me tell you, sometimes there's never been a better time to relive. It gets to be a sort of a pain during the night when you're sleeping and you're worried about it. Thought they would have got it wrong.
Yeah.
I actually thought they would get it wrong. Jim Axelrod. See, he's got a pacemaker defibrillator, and there's the box for that. It's not working either because we're not having a power. This helped. And they actually told me yesterday that went out the window when something like this happened. They sure were. And you know what? Up until today, in Raleigh, and he didn't do a whole lot. Come on, Missy Chrissy. Pop cords. And his bed, the foot part was up and the head was down a little bit, so he was actually.
That's the catch, yes.
The hard work they put in today.
They keep the blinds open and the sun comes in and that helps us.
To warm it up, yeah. We did finally get some sun today. CBS News. Feels like it's been forever since I've seen
sun. I know.
Still ahead, the great debate.
You ain't been cold. You've been frozen. Have I kept you warm?
Yeah.
Have I tried?
Oh yeah. Well, I'm hoping that at 11:45, you guys are just going to see the lights in this house come on. I really do.
I hope it comes on for 11.
I do too, but I hope it at least 11:45.
And I know we shouldn't get no more fun. All around it. I've got drop cords going. Oh, look, my bar's on this.
You're fine.
So the drop cord's going to the refrigerator.
To keep your food okay?
So y'all won't trip. I've got that, and then last night I cooked with the electric frying pan yesterday. I'm not even able to wash the dishes, because I don't have any extra. You don't have to shove my dirty sink, though.
No.
All the cords is that way because I brought them in through the bathroom window in there so that I didn't have to, because I got some outdoor cats and I didn't want them trying to come in the house.
Oh, true.
So I got it all pulled in through the back window back there. And so it's a lot easier too because I got duct tape. I don't know if you saw that in there while I got duct tape up there by the window ledge to close off the air coming in.
But you can still feel the difference in that room.
Oh, yes. A lot of difference.
Big time. Okay.
So, but anyways.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Well, thank you so much.
And this is your cord, and this goes all the way back?
Yep, it goes all the way back into the bathroom back here. Yeah. I got it draped.
Mm-hmm.
And then I got that one to the satellite so that he can mm-hmm. see satellite. And he saw in the trash can in here where I had to...
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Where I got them all draped up.
Okay.
And I walked right in the middle of you.
No, you're fine.
Yeah, good evening, guys. You know, the big question for people without power is when will it come back on? One of those neighborhoods is right here on Driver Road in Johnston County. It's a tiny little dead-end road with only 13 people who are desperate to get their lights and their heat turned back on. Good evening. You know, the big question for everyone who doesn't have power is when will it come back on? That question being asked tonight by this little road. No, that's stupid.
By this little road.
I know.
Hey, Driver Road.
Right.
Where's my power?
Hang on. Okay.
3, 2. Yeah, good evening. You know, the big question for people still waiting for power is when. One of those neighborhoods right here on Driver Road in Johnston County. It's a tiny little dead-end road with only 13 homes, but it's people who are desperate to get their lights and their heat turned back on. Car. Now, Duke Energy said they hope to have the power turned back on by 11:45, only minutes away here. We will keep you posted on when these families are able to turn their heat and power back on. In Johnson County, John Rodriguez, WNCN News.
Okay.
Now, Duke Energy estimated they would have the lights turned on by 11:45 tonight. I am very thankful to say that I just got a call from Belinda, and she says the lights and the heat are back on. In Johnson County, I'm Jonathan Rodriguez, WNCN News. 2.
Okay.
3. Now, Duke Energy estimated they would have the power back on by 11:45 tonight. It hasn't happened yet, but we'll, of course, keep you posted right here on WNCN. In Johnson County, I'm Jonathan Rodriguez, WNCN News.
By nearly 30 trucks.
I don't want to call right away.
It's away from Belinda's home. We found this staging area. We've got about now this is a live shot talk. It's got to be like a transition.
What? I don't know. Okay.
actually almost in, less than 5 minutes away from
the window. I know you do. It's your favorite part. Just do it then. It's fine.
But I gotta say, what are you saying between them?
Then the road. Just do a tag, man. Just do a tag.
Well, the thing is, that's, it will be a look like. At least part will not be here. But...
You don't know.
Yeah, but if they're not, I mean, that's...
Nobody's gonna come check. I don't see what the difference is.
Yeah, but
it's weird.
Something's happening.
It's weird to begin with to do a look live either way for me, but. Yeah, but then you're trying to fake that you're live.
Maybe we say around 8 o'clock.
Yes, exactly. You don't have to, it's not have to be a fake live, you know?
No, I mean, around 8 o'clock, that's this. It's about 30 Duke Energy trucks.
I meant you could use this as a tag and still say around 8 o'clock. It's not like you're trying to fake live. You're not trying to trick people live.
That's kind of what they want to do.
I know, but that's the part that I don't like.
Yeah.
So
I don't want to trick, but I also don't want to say it.
So what? So it was 3 hours ago.
Now.
Oh, man. All right, whatever. All right, you ready?
Yeah. You're going to start where?
Over there.
Because I was going to point to my phone.
Okay, I'll come to you quick.
Well, maybe not. I'll just say.
Alright.
Can we found
sorry,
this?
Sorry.
3, 2. Well, it's about 8 o'clock and we found the staging area. We've got about 30 utility trucks out here, only 5 minutes away from Driver Road.
Can you come over here a little bit? Let's get right there. Okay, ready? Alright.
3, 2. Well, it's about 8 o'clock and we found the staging area with about 30 utility trucks and it's only 5 minutes away from Belinda's house. 3, 2. Well, it's about 8 o'clock. We found this utility... Oh, sorry. 3, 2. Well, it's about 8 o'clock. We found the staging area. There's probably about 30 utility trucks sitting out here and we're only 5 minutes away from Belinda's house.